Yes? Pursue peace with everyone and sanctify yourself and you'll see that. It's easy. Huh? It's easy, right? Two steps. Pursue peace. How many want to see God? Hallelujah. It means that in this season, people of God, we have to sacrifice. You have to be able to sacrifice the bad relationships that you have. You gotta fix some relationships. Be at peace with some of those people that you call your enemies. Some of those people that you've not spoken to for a while. Some of those people that you've rejected and put to the side and call them names and call them this and that. And they don't even realize how much you speak about them every single day. But you wash them up and down every single day that you wake up. But God is saying that in this particular season, because you're willing and wanting to see me, I need you to seek. It says, I love how the scripture says, it says, pursue. It means run after it. You have to do it. You've got to do something about your situation. Change requires change. Hallelujah. You got to change your steps. You got to change the way that you do things in order to see the change manifested in your life. I cannot expect for a change to come if I'm still doing the same thing that I used to do, if I'm still hating the way that I used to hate, if I'm still speaking with the same bad words that I used to speak, if I'm still looking at situations and circumstances in the same manner that I looked at them yesterday. The Bible is calling us to be cleansed from the inside out. See, he says to the people, I want you to go and tell my people to consecrate themselves and to wash their garments. See, that's the scriptures we read. So in other words, I need them to be clean from the inside out. See, your sanctification cannot just limit itself to you saying, I'm sanctified. People have to see that you're clean. People have to see you clean. Hallelujah. I can't find you in the clubs anymore. Hallelujah. I can't catch you in the things you used to do yesterday anymore. People have to be able to see it. Well, God sees my heart. Y'all can't judge me. Y'all can't say, only God can. The devil is alive. That's not even the scripture. Hallelujah. The Bible calls each and every one of us. Do you know that you are a saint and God calls you to judge other saints? Hallelujah. This is scripture. The Bible says, do you not know that you will judge angels? You will judge angels with God. It says scriptures. God is calling us to be in a place of realizing that he wants to associate us in what he's doing. That it will take a certain level of preparation, transformation, change towards holiness. See, this is the season where we have to go back a little bit to what we used to do. We have to go back a little bit to the old school church where it was not just patty cake and playing around, where we only pray for 30 minutes and everybody's tired so we send you home. We got to go back to the place where we say, God, if it's not you, then we don't want nothing. If we don't walk with you, then we are not walking with nobody. If you don't do or show yourself, then we don't want to go anywhere. If you don't move, if you don't speak to me, God, then I am not going anywhere until I see you. See, this is the hour where we go back and get on our knees and begin to seek after the face of God. He says, tell the people to consecrate themselves for 2 days, the first day and the second day, consecrate, wash themselves, wash their garments, let themselves be seen from the inside out to be clean. Because on the third day, I will come. The third day. Now, what does that sound like? It sounds kind of familiar, right? 2 days, you go and clean yourself, but then the third day, the glory of God comes. It is a typology of the resurrection of the Christ. In other words, what I want you to do for 2 days and it is die within yourself. I want you to forget about your ideology, forget about your personality, your titles, and everything that you're about. Put those to the side. Kill those particular things. Lay them on the altar. Wash them yourself, because you're about to come into a greater presence of who I am. And in order for you to meet me in my fullness, I need you to die first. Nobody entered into the holy of holy places in the tabernacle unless something was killed on the outside. You can't get into the presence of God with your dirty self. You can't get into the presence of God with your dirty mouth and your dirty ways, and you expect for God to open up doors in your life, and you're wondering, why is it that I'm not seeing the blessings of God? We've been playing fake church long enough. We've been pretending long enough to where we come over here and we act as if we played a part, but in reality, something on the inside of us is still not right. It's still not working right. And God is saying, consecrate yourself. Consecrate yourself. Prepare yourself. Die on the inside. Kill some of those habits of yesterday. Let go some of those habits from yesterday. Let go some of those things that you carried along with you. The Bible declares that when the people of Israel went out of Egypt, they went out with new blessings. They didn't carry Egypt with them, but God blessed them with new things for the new land. God is saying that in this thing that you're about to enter, I need you to carry new habits. I need you to carry a new personality. You can't deal with me. You cannot associate with me until you carry new things. Hallelujah. I want to see the glory of God. Listen, I want you blessed. I want you blessed so bad. Every day of your life, I want you blessed. But you got to want it more than I want it. You've got to want it. See, a lot of times I look at the way we worship. Sometimes I look at the way we pray. And I ask myself, do they really want it? Do you really want God? Hallelujah. I cannot pray you through your consecration. Uh-uh. Everybody's got to come for themselves.
Hallelujah.
See, here's what God says to Moses. He says, Moses, tell the people, when you come here, tell the people not to touch the mountain, because they'll die. Huh? Tell the people, when they get near to the mountain, my glory is coming to the top of the mountain. My presence will be on the top of the mountain. But at the foot of the mountain, I need you to put a fence all around. And tell the people not to cross the fence. If they cross the fence, they die. Let me jump quickly, because of time. And then God comes down. The Bible says that the glory of God came down so tremendously that it came in the form of fire. And as God came down as fire, it consumed everything on the mountain. And the Bible says that Mount Sinai was smoke. There was smoke coming off the mountain like a cloud. Hallelujah. In other words, the fire of God burned. I could imagine that there was trees, there was things on this particular mountains, on the field of the mountain. Everything was consumed, and in the only thing that was left was smoke. And the smoke was going up. And God said, tell the people, in other words, don't walk into my fire if you're not ready, because you will get consumed. But he says to Moses, because he knew that Moses was ready. Watch this. It says, Moses, I need you to come up. Hallelujah. Say, tell the people to stay inside, but I need you to come up the mountain. And Moses went up the mountain. I'm here to tell somebody, you're the Moses for this season. The thing that will consume other people, the thing that will consume other people is going to be your glory. It's going to be the area that God will differentiate you. The reason why God has to move supernaturally in this season, listen to me very carefully. God has to allow you to walk into the fire for people to believe in the supernatural.
Amen.
I told you in the beginning, people have to see. They have to see something they haven't seen before.
Amen.
People had to witness Moses going up into a place where everything was being consumed. But the supernatural nature of God in Moses made it to where Moses walked up the mountain filled with smoke without being consumed. Listen to me. Whatever is coming against the world in this season will not consume. It may consume them. It will not consume. And when it does not consume you, they will run to you and say, what God are you praying? What is the God that you are seeking? Who is this God that is coming after you and giving you the ability to move so supernaturally? Your walk and your steps will no longer be the same anymore. Places that you will walk into, they will ask themselves, who is this man? Who is this woman? But the only reason that you are differentiated is because you've been consecrated by God. See, what they don't understand is that it's the God in me, but the God in me lives in me because there's been a sacrifice. We want the glory, but we don't want the sacrifice. We want the anointing of God, but we don't want to give up anything for it. But God is saying, this is the season where I need you to break everything. I need you to die for 2 days. I need you to put aside all those things because the third day you're about to resurrect. But your resurrection can only come whenever you give yourself away, when you sanctify yourself. This past Wednesday we were praying and God kept on saying to us, sanctify yourself, prepare yourself. I told you guys that we're here. You'll understand this Sunday. Hallelujah. That sanctify yourself, prepare yourself, purify yourself, wash yourself, because what you're about to walk into is a different level. We're about to walk into a different dimension, people of God. We're about to walk into a different season. If you're still sleeping, you will miss what God is doing in this hour. But I urge you to begin to prepare yourself and begin to put yourself in your closet and say, God, I don't know what you have going on in this hour. I don't know what you're doing, but I don't want to miss it. If you're moving in this season, don't move without me. If you're speaking in this season, don't speak without me. If you're healing in this season, don't heal without me. If you're anointing in this season, don't anoint without me. I want to be part of the glory of God. I want to be part of the anointing of the Almighty. I want to be used by you. I want the smoke, the glory, the fire of God to just begin to rise up all around me. All around me. They have to talk about you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You read books and you read about men and women of God that God used tremendously. And you read about how they would walk into a place and the glory of God would fill the place. Hallelujah. That's you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. That can be you. Amen.